So we are going to do today sectors of Indian economy. What do you see on the first page of the chapter? There are few pictures which you can see. The people are doing different activities. So let us start with the right side first activity on the top. Right side first activity on the top. If you see this, what type of activity is this? Any one of you, what type of activity is this? What type of activity is this on the right side top? Yes,
Pardon, please.
the person is delivering something. Can you see? Maybe he is a
Three.
postman or a courier person. He's
Tertiary.
it is a
Tertiary activity.
tertiary activity. Yes. Because it is a service which that person is doing. Okay, just below that, you know who is he? He is a coolie who is carrying the luggage on the head. Okay, what is the kind of activity this we call it as? Samiksha.
I'm again tertiary.
Again, tertiary activity. Good. Okay, now just below that is right side corner. Right side corner. The women are plucking. It can be cotton balls or it can be flowers, anything. So, what is that activity?
Mom, primary
Yes,
activity.
it is primary activity. Then, left side first pick. They are making bricks. You can see with that soil. Yes.
Home secondary.
Primary.
Secondary activity. Making bricks. Yes. Then left side corner, second picture, a woman is selling clothes. It is a tertiary activity. Yes. That's what is the picture description over there. Because every time the children are joining, I have to go back and then. Okay, we go to the next page. Now we come to the what are these activities which we have seen in the picture? They are primary activities, secondary activities, and tertiary activities. When I talk about any primary activity, what is this primary activity all about? Primary activity is activity which is related with nature. There is no processing. Processing can be done through machines. Processing can be done through hands also. So there is no processing in the primary activity. We are directly exploiting the natural resources. We are directly in connection with the natural resources. So that is called as the primary activity. Like we have so many examples for primary activity. Agriculture is the most important primary activity. In the same way, we have dairy farming, a primary activity. Forestry is a primary activity. Fishing is a primary activity. And these all activities are generally related with agriculture. So, primary sector or primary activities also called as agriculture sector or agriculture activities. They are also called as agriculture sector or agriculture activities. That is another name for primary activities. Second one we have secondary activity. Now, the term itself tells primary means the basic activity. Okay, secondary means the second step of the activity where the raw materials are converted into finished products. It can be done, as I told you, it can be done in a factory, it can be done even in the household sector also, but they convert raw materials into a product which can be used by the consumers. So that is why it is called as the secondary activity. Now, secondary activity has another name, children. It is also called as manufacturing sector, or it is also called as industrial sector. Examples, there are so many. When the cotton balls are plucked and they are converted into fibers, that is a secondary activity. In the same way, when the sugar cane is taken from the fields and then converted into sugar, gur or jaggery, that is also called as again the secondary sector, because that raw material is getting converted into the finished product. Then coming to the, we convert the soil into bricks and then make the houses with those bricks, buildings. So what is this conversion of soil into bricks called as? Again, it comes under the secondary activity, or it is also called as industrial sector. We come to the third sector, tertiary sector. Now, there is a basic difference between primary, secondary and tertiary sector. What is that basic difference? In primary and secondary sector, goods are produced. Maybe they are raw materials or finished products, but the goods are produced. But in tertiary sector, there are no goods produced. Only services are provided. That means people render their services. For example, a teacher is giving you her service. In the same manner, a doctor gives you a service. A banker gives you a service. A transporter gives you a service. So, that is basic difference between primary, secondary and tertiary. So, in tertiary, goods are not produced, but services are provided. This sector is also called as service sector, because here services are provided. Maybe he is a barber or a washerman or a lawyer or any administrator. Even the internet cafes, ATM booths, call centers, software companies, all of them are providing you the services which come under the tertiary sector. So that completes your first part, and with the exercise over there, children. So every part in economics you have exercise, and you don't have to leave any exercise, children. Even these can be asked from the table. It has been asked even this year also. So first one is done for you. Now here are the examples of interdependence of these activities. When we have done these three activities, can we say that we can live only with the primary activity and we don't require secondary and tertiary activity? No, we cannot say that. We need to have all the three activities. Now, how are they interdependent on each other? Primary sector provides basic raw materials to the secondary sector, without which the secondary sector cannot function. Without sugarcane, there cannot be any sugar. Without the cotton balls, there cannot be any fibers and the cotton cloth. So secondary sector is dependent on primary sector for the raw material. In the same manner, primary sector is also dependent on the secondary sector. Can anyone tell me that how primary sector is dependent on secondary sector? How primary sector dependent on secondary sector? Yes.
Mom, can I tell?
Yes.
Mom, primary sector is dependent on secondary sector, as secondary sector are providing them the electricity, pesticides, fertilizers for their agriculture.
Yes. Primary sector is dependent on secondary sector for so many, again, raw materials which can be used in the agriculture sector. For example, fertilizers are made in the industries, pesticides are made in the industries, there are so many machines, sprinklers, threshers, which are used in the irrigation pump sets. All these are made in the industries which are used by the agriculture sector. So they are also dependent on secondary sector. Now, tertiary sector. How is tertiary sector dependent upon them? Sashwat, you raised your hand. Sashwat, you raised your hand. How is tertiary sector dependent on these primary and secondary?
Mom, can I tell?
Yes.
Mom, tertiary sector is dependent on secondary.
Mom, tertiary sector is dependent on secondary.
Hello, Manya.
Mom.
Yes, speak up.
As mom, when they will.
Can you be little loud, Manya?
Mom, if they will not prepare the goods for people and mom will not be able to give them the goods, then mom tertiary sector will not be able to give.
Okay, how do you have to give is, tertiary sector, like all the service people, are dependent upon the primary and secondary goods. We are dependent upon the secondary goods for so many goods which we use in everyday life. In the same manner, on primary sector, we are dependent on. We are dependent on the grains which are produced by the agriculture sector. Now, how the primary and secondary sector dependent on tertiary sector? How primary and secondary sector dependent on tertiary sector? Yes.
Ma'am, if there would be no transportation, then their goods will not be able to reach the places where they want to sell. Or if there would be no banking services, then there would be no insurance of their crops or the manufactured goods which they have produced.
Yes, correct. Without transportation and communication, there cannot be the production of goods in primary and secondary sector. Then, as he has given example, if there is no banking, how the primary and secondary sector will take the loans? How they will share the loans? So they won't be able to share the loans. So you can see that is the, I will show you, somebody is asking me to annotate it, but I'll show you later that where are these interdependency is there. Okay. So before that, let's start with the first example on the in the table, then you will understand more, children. If you see the example, first example is here, which you can see here. You can see this is the first example. Imagine what would happen if farmers refuse to sell sugar cane to a particular sugar mill. The mill will have to shut down. I hope you have followed it. What will happen if the farmers will not sell sugar cane to the sugar mill? So what will happen to the mill? Mill will shut down. So who is dependent on whom here? Who is dependent on whom?
Tertiary is dependent on secondary sector.
Secondary on primary.
Secondary dependent on primary sector.
Primary sector.
Sugar mill comes under secondary. And yes, production of sugarcane comes under primary. So secondary sector, that is a mill or a factory, is dependent upon the primary sector for sugarcane. Now what you have to do, children, this is your homework, because right now I'll not do, otherwise it will take a lots of time, because in the next class I'll discuss this when you all do this exercise. So same way, just like the first example, you have second one, you have second example here, you have third example here, all these examples you will do. Okay, and fill with pencil. Don't fill with pen. Fill with pencil, because when I discuss in the next class, if you go anything wrong, you can correct it. Now, it is not necessary that in exam, they'll give exactly same situation. They can change some situation and give it to you. Okay. So that time also, you have to be careful that what example or what method they are asking and who is dependent on whom. You have to read one or two times annually. So you do these three parts on your own, then you will understand that where you are going, or when I discuss, you'll understand where you are done a mistake. So because some children are going and coming back, I don't know what is the problem and I am being troubled. This Moha Gupta has gone two times and he is joining again and again. Okay, anyway, come back to this part again. So we go to the next topic. Here also, children, there are exercises. I will do few for you, rest you will do, because there are, and do it in the book itself. You can do them here only. So second question, if you see, explain the difference between primary, secondary and tertiary sector using examples other than those mentioned. So I think we have already done lots of examples and the difference between primary, secondary and tertiary. So quickly we'll hear from Samiksha, who has raised her hand. Yes,
ma'am. Primary sector is involved with agriculture and direct use of natural resources, and ma'am, examples are farming, apiculture, cattle farming, etc. And ma'am, secondary sector, ma'am, large scale processing of natural resources and the goods produced by primary sector. And examples are, ma'am, industries such as iron and steel industry, sugar mill, and factories. And tertiary sector supports the activities of primary and secondary sector, such as banking, transportation, etc.
Yes, correct. So let's proceed to the next one. Classifying following list of occupations under primary, secondary and tertiary. So what you can do is you can write PST, a short form of the primary, secondary and tertiary. I'll again not do all. I'll only do few. Rest you will do it as homework. So tailor comes under which activity? Tailor. Shashwat?
Tertiary.
Tailor comes under tertiary activity. Yes. He is giving you the service. Okay. Basket weaver.
Primary.
Primary.
Basket weaving.
No, secondary. Secondary.
Comes under secondary activity. Yes. Okay. Workers in match factory. That is match box we are talking about. Workers in match factory.
Secondary.
Yes.
Secondary.
Secondary activity. Yes. So I'll leave here. I'll only discuss only this much. Rest of them, you do it on your own. In the next class, we will discuss also the next part. Okay. So let's proceed to the next part of the chapter. And one more thing, two students are taking attendance. This is for them. Both of you children, I'll not mention the name because I don't want the children to know your names and then later on they ask you to please put attendance. So I'm hiding your names. Those two students will mark attendance before 10 minutes of the class. Like today you mark at 9 o'clock because some are leaving in between once the class starts. So you don't mark attendance for them. Only 9 o'clock you mark attendance today. Both A and B section children. Okay. Now let's come to the next part. Comparing the three sectors. Children, I told you that how we have to now take out the GDP of the country. So we'll do what is GDP, how it is calculated. That we are going to do here with the example. So I'll read out the example later, but let me tell you first of all, what is it and how do we do it in a short way? Children, what is GDP first of all? You know, the full form of GDP is gross domestic product. Gross domestic product. Okay, now in the last class, you have done what is total income. When we taken out average income, you have taken out the total income. Now, GDP is the sum of the total income of all three sectors. GDP is sum of total income of all three sectors, primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. Okay, so whatever their total is, in primary sectors, their total income, secondary sectors' total income, and tertiary sectors' total income, all three together, when we add, we get the GDP. You know, it's a very tough task to add all these, and because there are so many activities, so much of population, so many different variation activities, it's very difficult, and it is done by our government of India. So it takes a lot of time to file to make this data. Now, coming to the one example I'll give you. Suppose how to calculate, that is, for that I am giving an example. Okay, Aditya Chaudhary means Pooja Chaudhary, because some are, I think, with their father's or mother's name. So those who are marking attendance can just see. Now, coming to the example, I'll give you a small example. There is a wheat producer, that is, in agriculture sector, we all know that wheat is produced. Now, this wheat is produced, and this farmer sells the wheat for rupees 10 per kg. I'm giving a small example. 10 rupees per kg wheat he has sold. He sold this wheat to a flour mill. You know what is flour mill? Where that powdered, that grains are powdered. Atta, which you call it as. So, it is sold to the grain seller. That flour seller. Now, after grinding it, flour seller sells this flour at rupees 15 per kg. He sells this flour at rupees 15 per kg to a biscuit factory. A biscuit factory, because in biscuit, the basic ingredient can be even wheat flour. So, and the biscuit factory, after converting this wheat flour, it uses all other ingredients also, sugar, ghee, etc. And it makes the biscuits and sells the biscuits for rupees 60 per pack. Rupees 60 per pack. You can even write this example just to understand. So, again I am repeating, grain seller has sold grains for rupees 10. And it has passed it to the wheat, the flour miller, where he converts the wheat into flour. And the flour miller has sold that flour to the biscuit factory for rupees 15 per kg. And the biscuit maker makes those biscuits and sells per pack 60 rupees. Now, the question to you is here, which value will be added to GDP? Which value will be added to GDP and why? Yes.
Mom, 10.
The last one, biscuit sellers.
Yes, last one is okay. Last one, biscuit sellers value will be added to GDP. Why? I asked a question, why? Anyone, you can raise hand so that I can see.
Final price.
Yes. Ayush, yes, somebody already told, it is final price. Ayush Savan.
We will see the final price only, because as it includes the price of the primary sector and also the secondary sector.
Yes, correct. Because the price of the final good, that is the biscuit, is already having the price of the wheat and the flour. So, that is why we do not add the value of the wheat, we do not add the value of the flour, but we add only the value of the biscuit, which is the final good. So, what is this? Now, biscuit is a final good. So, we are adding the value of that biscuit. But, what are these two goods then called as? That is the wheat and the flour, in the process of making the final good, they are called as intermediary goods. They are called as intermediary goods, which I'll show you. Okay, so this is the example which we are talking about. So when I talk about this, you can see here, there is an example here. Okay, with the prices, it's not necessary that you have to give the same prices. It's up to you. Like I have given an example, you can also give example, but please don't make a mistake when you are giving your own example. That's the only thing I want here. Okay, so all the examples are given here. Like if 10,000 kgs of wheat is sold at rupees 8 per kg, the value of wheat will be 80,000. The value of 5,000 coconuts at rupees 10 per coconut will be rupees 50,000. See, Yukti is joining now. Don't put attendance for her. Okay. So, that is the example. Then we have, you can see here, the terms are given here like final goods. Final goods and services. And the example is here, which I have told you. I have given you different figures, but they have used the different figures. That if the farmer sells his wheat 8 rupees per kg, biscuit company sells the biscuit pack for rupees 10 per kg, and say, the flour miller sells for rupees 10 per kg, and the biscuit is finally sold for rupees 60. So, which value is added? That is, biscuits value is added over here, which are the final goods. Now, the question is asked, which I asked you, why are final goods only and services are counted here, which we have already done, because they already include the value of wheat and wheat flour, which are the examples of intermediary goods. Children, I am not so good in annotating, so that's why the lines are going here and there. So you can just see, I think. So intermediate goods are used up. What are intermediate goods? They are the goods which are used up in making the final goods and services. They are the goods which are, you can say one way, they are inputs, and the final good is the output. Okay, so they are the goods which are used to produce the final goods. So children, they may ask you, what are intermediate goods, or differentiate between intermediate goods and the final good also. So please just go through these definitions which I have told you also. So final goods are the goods which are directly for selling purposes in the market, which reaches the consumers directly. They are the final goods. Intermediate goods are the inputs which are used to produce the final good. So in this example, the biscuit is the final good. So we go to the next part over there. What happened, Shashwat? He raised hand. Shashwat, what happened? You want to ask anything? Shashwat? Because you raised your hand. I can't hear you, Shashwat. See, whosoever is speaking, please speak little loud. Okay, now we come to here, the definitions of GDP. You can see in the first paragraph with the black letters over there, the value of final goods and services produced in each sector during a particular year provides the total production of the sector for that year. So you can see the value of the final goods that is taken in each sector, and that provides the GDP. And there is a further definition also here, which you can see in the same paragraph. How will you define GDP? Sum of production in the three sectors gives us GDP. It is the value of all final goods and services produced within a country during a particular year. This is called as GDP. So I'm repeating the definition of GDP: value of all final goods and services produced within a country during a particular year. And GDP shows how big the economy is. So through GDP also we can know that which country is developed and which country is developing. And I told you that calculating GDP is such a difficult task because we have so many, we have nail making to the car making, so many goods in the market, so many different types of productions are there in the market. So it's not easy to calculate their values, and this task is done by the central government ministry. And this ministry, with the help of various government departments in the various states and union territories, they collect the information and then finally takes out the GDP. So that's about your primary sector, secondary sector, how to calculate GDP and definition of GDP, how three sectors are dependent on each other. I think the time up, children, and that's all for today. You can go through this. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the next class, and also complete your the